Describing an elephant seal takes all of your senses. They smell really strong. They sound really loud. They're really, really hairy. But even what we can see and smell and hear doesn't give you a full picture of an elephant seal because most of their time they're spending out in the open oceans. So really 90% of their life, they're not on the coast. We can't see them. We have no idea what they're doing. My lab is really interested in figuring out what is happening in the open ocean. So we're studying elephant seals and instrumenting them with tracking devices that give us information about what might be happening in the open ocean and what we can do to protect it. Our campus is in Santa Cruz, California. Right off the shore here is Monterey Bay, which is this incredibly diverse natural system. And that allows there to be a ton of large marine vertebrates like seabirds and seals and whales that make Monterey Bay their home. Elephant seals are some of the best animal athletes. They regularly dive down to thousands of meters below the ocean surface. And there are seals that go really far north towards Alaska and seals that go really far west toward Japan. And part of our research is trying to unravel why certain seals go to certain places. And so they're really natural samplers of the ocean environment. We can now put these pretty small satellite tags on elephant seals. So this particular tag is called a splash tag. You can see the antenna here that actually transmits information to satellites, which if you see a picture or a video of a seal with a tag on its head, the reason we put it on the head is so the antenna can actually break the surface of the seawater and it can actually transmit to the satellites. The tag itself collects lots of incredible data. You can see this is GPS. This here is a temperature sensor. It has a depth sensor, and we get this full comprehensive sense for not only what's happening in the water in terms of the salinity and the temperature, but also where the seal is going and how deep it's diving. Working with animals is not a responsibility that we take lightly, and so it's really important to us that we're doing the least amount of harm and the most amount of good that we can. We're always monitoring seal behavior and seal success, so how much food they're able to find. And between those two things, we're able to get this really comprehensive understanding of ocean health at a pretty unprecedented scale. The unrestricted funding of the Packard Foundation Fellowship has been just fundamental to developing my lab. Doing science right takes a lot of time and energy. I think when you start as a faculty member, there's so much uncertainty about the direction that you're going. So having a little bit more freedom in the types of decisions I can make has been hugely helpful. The students play so many critical roles. I think when I started, I knew I wanted to train the next generation, but I didn't realize how integrated mentoring and research would be in my research program. I'm still learning things every day. They're teaching me all sorts of stuff, things like important parts of their culture that are important for them to bring to their work, or new approaches to statistical modeling or to mapping that they're learning in other internships that they're part of. And we've been able to sort of collaboratively develop our whole program together, and that means that it can serve them even better in the future. Science is really only so good as the conservation actions that can come out of it, because our planet is changing really quickly and we're trying to secure this sort of Earth future for us and for the next generation. And so it's important to us that we not only make these discoveries and put them into really critical ecological contexts, but it's important to us too that we think about forming conservation action.